Welcome to this series of videos on accessibility requirements for public procurement of ICT products and services in Europe, the EN301549 standard. This is the sixth video. It's sponsored by Microsoft and produced by Funke. My name is Susanna Loren. I'm an accessibility expert with a long experience in standardization. In this video, we are going to look into Chapter 6 of the EN standard. This chapter covers ICT with two-way voice communication. You may ask yourself, what does ICT with two-way voice communication really mean? In this context, it simply means that two or more persons communicate via some sort of ICT using their voices. This could, for example, be a door entry phone or when you participate in a digital meeting using a computer or a smartphone. The EN standard is here to help. Please note that this chapter contains some information on video regarding lip reading and sign language, but Chapter 7 deals with more general requirements on video. ICT with two-way voice communication. 6.1 has to do with audio bandwidth for speech. In 6.2, we learn about real-time text, also called RTT functionality. 6.3 has to do with caller identification, and 6.4 covers alternatives to voice-based services. 6.5 is video communication, and 6.6 has alternatives to video-based services. 6.1, audio bandwidth for speech. If the ICT provides two-way voice communication, good audio quality is essential. Therefore, the ICT should use a frequency range with an upper limit of at least 7,000 Hz. This is important for all users, but especially for hard of hearing users. The 7,000 Hz is a minimum requirement. You are free to include higher frequencies as well. There are specific protocols suitable for supporting interoperability and to avoid transcoding, but we will not go into the details here. 6.2, real-time text functionality, or RTT. This is like a text message in which users do not have to hit the enter or return key to send a message. This solution is not yet deployed on a larger scale. The first heading of this subsection has to do with RTT provision. When the ICT provides two-way voice communication, the user must also be able to use real-time text instead. The possibility to use RTT can be provided per default or added later. To make the real-time text work, it might be necessary to add hardware or software. These can be added separately or together. Concurrent voice and text. When the ICT supports two-way voice communication, it must be possible for the user to choose to use voice and text at the same time. When voice and text is provided together, the real-time text can replace or support voice and add information such as numbers and spelling out difficult words. The second heading of this subsection covers the display of real-time text. Visually distinguishable display means that the user must be able to see the difference between messages that he or she writes and messages that he or she receives. Programmatically determinable send and receive direction. This might sound complicated, but it means that a screen reader, which is an assistive technology used by, in this case, blind users, should be able to understand the difference between incoming and outgoing text when used with the real-time text functionality. Since neither the screen reader nor the blind user is able to see the visual difference, it must be possible to tell what is what in the code. That way, the screen reader can communicate this to the user if necessary. The third heading of this subsection has to do with interoperability. In this context, interoperability means that the ICT can communicate and function together with other systems without restrictions. This is often ensured by using a specific standard or protocol. The real-time text must support a number of conditions where specific protocols are suitable. But the standard also allows for new protocols to emerge to preserve a path to innovation. You can find references to these specifications in the EN standard. The fourth heading of this subsection is real-time text responsiveness. Real-time text input must be supported by the ICT network within 1 second. This means that it must not be more than a 1 second delay after the user has entered a character or word. What is considered input can differ depending on if the user writes one character at a time or if the system generates input from speech or some kind of word prediction. Again, you will find references to suitable protocols to support this in the EN standard. 6.3. Caller identification. The user must be able to understand who is calling in at least 2 ways, text and something else. That could, for example, be a photo of the person who is calling. 6.4. Alternatives to voice-based services. If the ICT offers real-time voice-based communication or some kind of interactivity using voice communication, there must be a way for the user to carry out the task without hearing or speaking. A solution that combines audio, real-time text, and video can meet this requirement. 6.5. Video communication. This chapter has requirements for users that need sign language or lip reading. The basic technical requirements are Common Intermediate Format, or CIF, resolution, a frame rate of at least 20 frames per second, with a time difference between speech audio and video that does not exceed 100 milliseconds. If the resolution is reduced to Quarter Common Intermediate Format, or QCIF, and the frame rate drops to 12 frames per second, the communication can still be usable in some circumstances. Lower resolution is less of a problem for users that need sign language or lip reading than a lower frame rate. It is important to provide as little delay as possible. 0.1 second is preferred, but up to 0.4 seconds can work. If the delay is more than 0.8 seconds, it will hinder good sign language conversation. But delay can, of course, depend on many different factors, for example, the network, or the way the video is being processed. This is why there are no testable requirements on minimum values for delay. 6.6. Alternatives to video-based services. When the ICT provides real-time video-based communication, and also some kind of interactivity using voice communication, the ICT must provide the user an alternative way to access information and perform the task. For example, if the information is provided via audio, it must be possible to understand without hearing. If the commands are to be made via voice, it must be possible to do it without speaking. If the information is provided visually, it must be possible to understand without seeing. If the ICT can generate real-time captions or real-time text, this could meet this requirement. Remember, users are different, so for everyone to be able to communicate, you need to provide alternatives. If the user can choose the way he or she is most comfortable with, communication becomes much easier for all of us. If you would like to know more, please have a look at our other videos. There's one video for each chapter in the standard. Thanks for watching.